kind of interesting story to Love Takes Care, because we had just been watching AC/DC record. I don't know what song. It may have even been Let There Be Rock. But we were often in the studio when they were recording, and we'd hang about and watch them record, which was always an amazing experience. And sometimes they'd be in there when we were recording. So it was that kind of friendship that was going on.
Yeah, I didn't appreciate it fully. Probably none of us did at the time, because we were thrown into this situation of all these great bands in the same studio, you know, one would be recording next door, and we'd be recording in one studio, and we'd meet in the corridor, and, you know, step over John when he was having a heart attack.
But anyway, Bon Scott used to sing his vocals in the piano room. AC/DC had finished the session. I went into that piano room with an acoustic guitar and Doc, and the two of us sat down, and Doc had some lyrics. So we wrote Love Takes Care, which is probably very suitable to be like an acoustic song, but in those days George Young used to say just record them like you're playing on stage. So we had the guitars turned up, you know, and recorded the song that way.
George and Harry, they were like the central hub of everything that went on there. It would be AC/DC or Rose Tattoo or John Paul Young or Ted Mowry, and George and Harry doing their own songs. I remember Angus wandering in one day when we were doing something in the control room. He came in with his guitar and he was all excited. He said, I've got to show you this, got to show you. In his Scottish accent, this tiny little guy, this big guitar, and he's going, look at this, I can do these trills. And he's going, yong, 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 dong, yong, yong.
Pour that wine I'm making.